In this video, we're going to talk about something called conditional probability. The idea with a conditional probability is that we want to figure out the probability of something given that we have some other piece of information, some other piece of information that we can bring to the table that will influence the probability of whatever it is that we're investigating. Now, the way we write this down is with the following notation. We're going to refer to the probability of A given B. So this vertical bar that we have here is referred to as, or read off as, given. And what it means is this is the probability of A, the thing I want, the thing I'm investigating, the probability of some event A, given that I have this other piece of information, given that I know that this event B has occurred. So we want to have some formula for how are we going to compute this. It is a quotient of two things. It is the probability that we have both the event A and the event B. So I write this as an intersection. It means the probability of A and B, all divided out by the probability just of B. Now, the way I like to think about this formula is that we're looking not at all possible events. We're looking at this sort of narrowed sample space of knowing that this event B has occurred. And we're asking, well, what's the probability of A occurring given B? So the sort of sum total of all the possibilities are going to be whatever the possibility is B is going to be, because we know that B has occurred. But then we're asking, well, how often is it likely the case that you have A and B occurring amongst all of the possibilities where B occurs? So that's why we have this formula. This is, what is the probability that A and B occurs? That's the numerator divided by all the possible ways that B could occur. That's the denominator. Note that in most cases, if we're just talking about non-conditional probabilities, what the probability of A is without any other information, we actually are typically dividing by something the same way. It's just that we divide by the probability of all possible events, the entire sample space, the entire universe of possibilities, which is just one. So we are, in fact, always dividing out by something. And in the case of conditional probability, it's that we're dividing out by the probability of B, the thing that we're told has to exist. Now, we can sort of visualize how this is going to work by using a Venn diagram. So a Venn diagram, I'm going to list my entire universe of possibilities. And then I can say that, look, I have within my entire universe, I could have some probability of an event A occurring. And I could also have a probability of some event B occurring. Well, if I'm looking at this sort of conditional probability, well, conditional probability is saying, look, I'm in the scenario where this event B is occurring. I'm assuming that event B occurs. And then what I'm really interested in is, what is the probability of this event A occurring given that I'm in this event B and that event B has occurred? In which case, I'm really interested in this intersection here. In other words, I care about this ratio of the probability of the intersection to the probability of B occurring, the red divided out by the yellow here. Now in this example, I've given you something. I've given you an intersection. I've told you that the percent of adults who are both male and who are alcoholics is going to be, it looks like, 2.25%. I had to look this up. And then the question is, what is the probability that you're an alcoholic if you know that you're a male? We can look at what the probability of being an alcoholic is in general, but I'm interested in this problem. Is if you know that your patient is a male, what is the probability that they're an alcoholic? So we're going to use conditional probability to figure this out, because we know something about the intersection, the probability of being an alcoholic and a male, that's 2.25%. We know what the probability of being a male is, all approximated at 50%. And we can use those two facts together to get the conditional probability, the probability that you're an alcoholic given that you're an adult male. Now, I need to define a little bit of notation before I plug it into my formula. I'm going to let A, this is going to be equal to the particular event of being an alcoholic. And then I'm going to let B be the event that you're going to be a man. So there's two different things we could do. We could ask, what's the probability of an alcoholic? What's the probability of being a man? What's the probability of being an alcoholic and a man? That's the thing that we were given. We were given in particular that the probability of being an alcoholic and being a man, that this was equal to 0.0 0.225, or in other words, 2.25%. And so what we're really asking when I ask what is the probability that you're an alcoholic, given that you're a man, is we're asking what is the probability of being an alcoholic, given that you're a man. And we know that from our formula, this is going to be the probability of A intersect B, so the probability of being both, all divided by the probability of just B, in other words, the probability of being a man. And we know these two different answers. The top is going to be 0.0225. And then I'm going to be dividing this by the probability of a man, and I'm going to say that that's 0.5. I'm going to assume it's exactly 50%. And therefore, what I'm going to get is 0.045, or about 4.5% for adult males. By the way, it's a little bit smaller for adult females. It's about 2.5% for adult females. So this is a way that we've been able to compute this result, the probability of being an alcoholic given that you're a male, via this technique of conditional probability.